lecture. I'm delighted to find humorous in a good way.
It's
humorous, and I'm delighted that all of us paid attention to what Professor Richard McKirahan had to tell us, and let us open the discussion. And would you like to open the discussion? You have the question.
Yes.
I have the questions as well, but I don't know later on.
Well, I would ask you. Sophists actually said that music doesn't exist because everyone hears differently. Do you know something? You don't know who said it from our books from which we learned philosophy. So I you didn't find that who said it.
I identify the source.
I was hoping that the professor could do that for me. Yeah. Yeah. So it doesn't ring a bell. It could be true, but
music doesn't exist
because everybody hears differently. It's like they find out they're in Matrix of some kind before Schopenhauer or Descartes. But you wouldn't say.
Yes. Okay. This may be relevant.
Mm-hmm.
I think the most famous view attributed to any sophist is what we know as Protagorean relativity, which is to say what things are for you the way they seem to you, and things are for me.
Yes, like it is cold for me, but not for you, or
that's
it's
the example.
Bitter for me, but sweet for you.
That's the example. But from there, he goes on to compare it to. Put this together with something from Heraclitus to come up with a theory that no serious person would ever have put forward. And it was put forward by Plato in order to refute it. And he refutes it in about 9 different ways. And there's nothing left. It's an interesting theory to analyze for philosophical purposes and learn by it. But I think that even that much about the interpretation of Protagoras, I believe that is not Protagoras. I believe that is Plato. The way he says this, I don't have a test for him, of course, but I'm sure from the translation of Plato from the time. He starts off by saying, Socrates and PhDs. Socrates says to PhDs something like, Protagoras has something to say about this. And Theotetus says, yes, I know. I've read the passage many times. And then, so what he says is, anthropos, a human being is a measure. It could be humans in general, I don't know. Not anyway, anthropos is
a measure of all things. Yeah. Panton, metron, chromason.
Things that are or exist or whatever. There's lots of possible interpretations. That they are, and the things that are not. And then he says, by this rhetoric, the way it's set up, this is a quotation. This is the closest you get to a quotation, because he said, one person says it, and it's an attribute to that person, and the other one says, yes, I know it well, I read it many times. That's almost saying this is word for word what Protagoras said. It's also confirmed in other sources. These are Protagoras' words. And then by this, he says that all things are to me as they are to you, and all things are to you as they are to you. Well, if you read the frame, and you read this, and it's not saying that. I mean, these are not his words, and I don't think that he means that these are his words. We've already just heard what his words are. So Lego can also mean and mean. So it's implied. Here's the statement that I vouch for or words, and by this, he means this. And when philosophers start telling you that other philosophers mean,
they're mean.
Well, not necessarily, but The example I always give of this, it's true. I have the good fortune to be at Harvard as a graduate student, and one of the ones I like to admit. And it was just after John Rawls was a famous social enlightenment degree that you've heard of, but he was one of the best people in political and social philosophy in the 20th century. And he had just brought out this book called The Theory of Justice, which is that in California, I say this, and people who are taking courses in that area, so I'm just going to get that. So it's still a well-known book. And so he gave an undergraduate course. Ethics. And I went, lots of people went, we wanted to hear Rawls talk about ethics, because we need to learn from him. And then he said, I always say the last 3 weeks of the semester to talk about important figures in the history of philosophy. And I select Aristotle, and I select Kant, and Mill, because they have different approaches to philosophy, and I wanted to talk about it. So we talked about Aristotle. And he picked this passage, but they made the results out just black holes. And then he did Kant. And Kant sounded just like Rawls.
Yes, that's why our professor said that you cannot pull out, some quote from philosopher willy-nilly. You must learn